Good morning, class 7. So today is our 16th class, and today we will finish this chapter with the last topic, that is the tornado. Now, as you can see, I have already written the definition in our board to consume some to consume less time so that we can cover a greater portion of the remaining chapter. So as you can see, what are tornadoes? So actually, tornado, it is a violent storm. So what is tornado? Tornado is a violent, storm. So this term is very important. It is a violent storm. And what are the characteristics of this violent storm? It is a violent storm with a column of rapidly rotating waves. So you can find the similarity here, the similarity between the tornado and the cyclone. In both type of storms, so we are having a column of rapidly rotating wind, having the appearance of a dark funnel shaped cloud that reaches from the sky to the ground. So reaches from the sky to the ground. This is the first different point. As you have seen in the cyclone, it generally forms over the sea, and it starts forming from the surface of the sea and then it goes to the sky. But it reaches from the side, forms near to a very far distance from the ground, and that's why it reaches from the sky to the ground. Then the second one is, the most of them forms from thunderstorms. So they generate because of the thunderstorm. Then the high speed rotating wind creates very low pressure at its center. So it is same as the cyclone. The cyclone also has a low pressure center known as the eye of the cyclone. Here also for the tornado, we are having a low pressure center, very low pressure at its center around the rapidly rapidly rotating wind. Now, so the funnel of the tornado, as because it is this is also having a same kind of this is also having a very low pressure at its center. So the funnel of the tornado can suck dust, debris and everything else, whatever is present in their path, and which are loosely bound to the surface, to any surface. It can be dust, it can be debris. What does debris means? The destructive residue of many buildings, that means the broken bricks, concretes. So they are known as the debris. So dust, debris and everything else, whatever is loosely bound to the surface. What they do, they throw them at the top. So the funnel like structure, you can see it in the figure. It is given in figure 18.16. As you can see, it's a funnel like structure. That means the lower part is narrower compared to the upper part. So it sucks everything from the ground and it throws at the top. A violent tornado can travel at a speed of 300 km per hour. So, what we found? We found that it is a violent storm with a column of rapidly rotating wind, having the appearance of a dark funnel-shaped cloud that reaches from the sky to the ground. So, it generates over the ground, not over the sea. Most of them forms from the thunderstorm. The high speed rotating wind creates low pressure at its center. So the funnel of the tornado can suck dust, debris and everything else and throw them at the top. A violent tornado can travel at a speed of 300 km per hour. So you can see the traveling speed or the wind speed of the tornado is much greater than the cyclone. So that's why tornadoes are much more dangerous than the cyclone. Now, but the tornado are not very frequent in our country. So we do not evident the tornado as because it is not very frequent in our country. So with this you have got the clearance that how tornado is different from the cyclone. And with this we have come to nearly at the end of this chapter. Here we must take care of these points, that is the precautions to protect ourselves from tornado. So what precaution we must be taking during tornado, or to protect ourselves from tornado? One should take shelter in basement. So you have to keep it in your mind, if you are in a region where the tornado is supposed to hit the ground, then you have to take shelter in the basement or the underground room. One must bend down on their knee and can protect their head and neck using arms. So during the tornado, as you are supposed to experience a high destruction at that region, so protect your head and neck from such kind of injuries during the destruction. You should bend on your knees and you have to protect your head with your hand and neck. So you can see the picture. I think the picture is given here. Yes. Come to page 89 in the blue box. You can see that how the boy is protecting his head and neck from the tornado, the destruction caused by the tornado. Okay. So as you can see here also, in our country they are not very frequent. A tornado is a dark funnel shaped cloud that reaches from the sky to the ground, and the speed of the wind is 300 km per hour. The whole coastline of India is vulnerable to cyclones, particularly to the east coast. That is what I have already told you, and I have also told you that what precaution we must take during the cyclone, and also I have today I have told you what precaution you should take during the tornado. Okay, now let us come to the last section. That is, at first I would like to read the blue box given in page number 90, where it is written that we have learned that all storms are low pressure system. Obviously, when there is a huge difference in pressure, then only the storm arises. Wind speed plays an important role in the formation of storms. It is therefore important to measure the wind speed. The instrument that measures wind speed is called anemometer. So you can see in the figure, it has been shown to you what is an anemometer. The anemometer, if you are asked what is an anemometer, you will write that anemometer is a device which helps to measure the wind speed as well as the direction by seeing the rotation of the anemometer. Whether it is rotating in clockwise or anti-clockwise direction, with the help of that you can also predict the direction of the flow of wind. Okay, along with the speed of rotation, you will be able to measure the speed of the flowing wind. Now, Yes, in the last section, action on the part of the people. Let us read it. This section, we should not ignore the warnings issued by the meteorological department through TV, radio, or newspaper. We should make necessary arrangements to ship the essential household goods, domestic animals, and vehicles, etc., to safer place. Avoid driving on roads through standing water, because you won't be able to judge up to what area the road is, or if there is a manhole, or if there is a river beside the road, then you won't be able to judge the boundary of the road and the river. So if the water is in a standing condition, don't try to drive your vehicle on road through standing water, as floods may have damaged the road. And keep ready the phone numbers of all emergency services like police, fire brigade, and medical center. How can you keep the phone numbers ready? Not only it is not necessary that it is not enough that you are having all the emergency numbers in your cell phone, because today in the mobile phone we save all the emergency numbers, but we do not even try to keep a hard copy of that, or even we don't even try to memorize few of the very emergency numbers. So what happens during this type of situations, because of the power cut, if a situation arises, your cell phone becomes dead, then you won't be able to find out the emergency number and seek for the help. So it is always important to have a hard copy, that means in the written format. That also you have to keep it in a plastic bag so that it does not get wet during this situation. So you must keep, that's why it is written, it is mentioned that keep ready the phone numbers of all emergency services like police, fire brigade, and medical centers. Some other precautions, if you are staying in a cyclone hit area, then these are the things what I have already told you, that do not drink water that could be contaminated. Always store drinking water for emergency, because it is very important to store some amount of drinking, a good amount of drinking water with you always, along with some dry foods and dry fruits. Okay, do not touch wet switches and fallen power lines. Do not go out just for the sake of the fun that what had happened. Let's see, let's take a visit to the different destruction places out of curiosity or out of some adventurous feeling. Don't do that. Okay, do not pursue the rescue force by making undue demands. So that is what I have told you in my previous class. It is very unpolite or immature behavior to demand different types of advantages to the rescue teams at that situation. Cooperate and help your neighbors and friends. It is not about you and yourself only. It is always about to help others. That is why we are called civilized. But nowadays we are forgetting all those things. But when the emergency situation comes, yes, we have to think of ourselves, we have to think of our family, but along with that, we must try to help others. That what makes us different from other animals. That's why we are intellectual, we are civilized. Okay, then last thing is that advanced technology has helped. So nowadays, because of this advanced technology, it has become much easier to forecast this type of destructive cyclones and tornadoes very easily to us. And this technology also helps us to prepare ourselves, because they can forecast this type of situations many days before the actual hitting of these type of test structures. So these days we are better protected. In the early part of the last century, coastal resident may have had less than a day to prepare or evacuate their homes from an oncoming cyclone. The world today is very different. Thanks to the satellites and the radars, a cyclone alert or cyclone watch is issued 48 hours in advance of any expected storm, and a cyclone warning and is issued 24 hours in advance. So we get enough time to prepare, not only we, the people who are living in those type of areas, not only us get the adequate amount of time to prepare ourselves, but also the government also gets to prepare the rescue team to do the necessary, they can also take the necessary steps to secure a huge amount of lives from this kind of destructions. The message is broadcast every hour or half hour when a cyclone is nearer the coast. Several national and international organizations cooperate to monitor the cyclone-related disaster. So, see the focus on the last line, that several national and international organizations cooperate to monitor the cyclone-related disaster. So, this shows that though we are living in different boundaries, but when a situation like this comes, then every nation has to cooperate with each other, otherwise it becomes very difficult to survive. So this is the message, this is the message with what science give us, that we are the people, we can remain superior, we can take care of ourselves only because of the health of the others. So it is not all about ourselves. It is not about the self-centered character. It is about the well-being of all the humankind. So that's why I would like to urge you, when you are reading the signs, please try to develop this kind of attitude and characteristics in yourself. If you are thinking of taking a future in this science field, because nowadays this has become much more important to focus on the well-being of all the humankind. Okay, so that's all. So with this we have completed the chapter. Please go through the chapter once again, so that in my next class when I will come up with the exercise, you will be able to utter all the answers at your home. Though I won't be able to hear you, but I hope if you will practice well, then along with me you will be able to utter all the answers. Till then, take care and keep practicing.